was playing in the front yard with our old dog Gonzo and a little puppy her parents gave her on her 11th birthday. The sun was shining hot and not a cloud was in sight. In the kitchen her parents stood happily smiling when they looked at their little daughter playing with her dogs. They got a real hot swell. The little girl threw a ball and Gonzo ran away to fetch it. The little puppy ran after and suddenly they were out on the streets chasing the ball. It was a green tennis ball. But from the left side came a speeding truck with a drunken truck driver at the wheel. The little puppy was so contained in his game that he has not noticed the truck before it was too late.
Puppy heaven, a place for a friend. Puppy heaven, that's where it will end. Puppy heaven, a place for a friend. Puppy heaven, that's where it will end.
Brake screaming and the smell of burnt rubber etched on in the little girl's mind. The sound that broke out of the little girl's throat could give any stony man who preferred goosebumps. Placed on both sides of the street, forked in two pieces, her beloved little puppy, chopped in two pieces. Very distraught by grief, and she wept rivers of tears, rivers of tears. Her mother tried in vain to piece together the puppy. She even tried to glue together the little puppy, all in vain. The whole family sat down together on the lawn and they prayed to the great almighty Father in heaven for a miracle. God said, I can turn back time and I can make things never happen. The truck driver's name was Big Ed. He was working for General Motors in Detroit. Born in Milwaukee, but raised in Chicago by an alcoholic father and a go-go dancer named Abigail.
Puppy heaven, a place for a friend. Puppy heaven, that's where it will end. Puppy, where it will end.